What's going on, everybody? It is week 11 in this fantasy football season. It is do or die for most teams. Most leagues, week 13, week 14 is the end of the season. Hopefully you're contending for one of those last few playoff spots. That's why you need to listen right now, because I have news that might be able to help you and some waiver wire pickups that will definitely help you, especially if you're in need of a quarterback like me. I have just recently lost Nick Foles and Carson Palmer. I have been desperate for a quarterback. I had to make a trade for Cam Newton because I did not trust what was out there on my waiver wires. But I've got a few names that hopefully will be available in your leagues. Let's start with this Week 11 matchup. You have Buffalo at Miami, Atlanta at Carolina. That is going to be a good game for both quarterbacks. I think Cam Newton bounces back and has a great game, although 300 yards and two touchdowns were not bad, unless you're in a league where you get deducted by interceptions, and then the three interceptions probably hurt you. Minnesota, Chicago, Houston at Cleveland, Seattle, Kansas City, Cincinnati at New Orleans. Oof, I'm a little bit worried about those Cincinnati offensive pieces. Jeremy Hill did not do much last week. Giovanni Bernard still banged up. You know, trade deadline is also this week. I would be looking to selling any Cincinnati Bengals that I have. San Francisco at the Giants, Denver at St. Louis, Tampa Bay at Washington. You have Oakland, San Diego, Detroit at Arizona. Now, keep in mind, Arizona is going to be without Carson Palmer for the rest of the season. I predict a big Detroit win on this one. Philly at Green Bay. Hopefully, you were one of those guys to get Mark Sanchez. I feel dirty. I feel like I should just hop in the shower that I just said, play Mark Sanchez in fantasy football. Wow. How the times are changing on you. Anyways, New England, Indianapolis, and yeah, Pittsburgh at Tennessee is your Monday night game. All right, let's talk a little news. We got a lot coming out. It's very running back heavy. Ryan Matthews looks to play this week, 15 to 19 touches. You know what? If you're desperate, play him. That's all I can really tell you. Everybody else should be set, especially Brendan Oliver. His value goes down to zero. I would look to trade him just before everybody catches wise on that thing. Rashard Jennings is set to play in week 11 if you've been sitting on him. Now, Adrian Peterson, I am selling him. If you're set, listen, I had, in a standard league, I got Julius Thomas for Adrian Peterson. What's that tell you about Adrian Peterson's value right now? He has a hearing set for November 22nd to find out if he'll play. The NFL is dragging their feet. They could have heard this on the 17th, but they chose to wait till the 22nd. They don't want him to play the season, and I think they're going to find a way to keep him out of action. Giovanni Bernard, like I said, is out for week 11. Jeremy Hill is a start. Monty Ball, probably going to play in week 11. Keep an eye on C.J. Anderson. We'll talk about him in a few minutes, but Monty Ball. And Ronnie Hillman is going to be out 2 to 3 weeks. I was caught blindsided by this. You know, he's one of these guys that I owned, and now I'm trying to fill a hole. He's been a solid flex play for me. So, you know, you're going to be out without Hillman until at least the playoffs. And then who knows, depending on how Ball and Hillman do, or Ball and Anderson do, it may affect Hillman's value going into the fantasy playoffs. But speaking of C.J. Anderson, he's one of my top pickups of the week. After netting 160 yards and a touchdown last week, he is one of those guys that everybody's after. You go pick him up. Jordan Matthews, wide receiver for Philadelphia. 7 catches for 138 and 2 touchdowns. And Mark Sanchez is his quarterback. Again with the Mark Sanchez. Go out and pick him up. I like Jordan Matthews. Normally, I would say rookie wide receiver, but after what Odell Beckham has done and a couple other of these young kids, hey, go get him. Mike Evans, I think he could probably be the same, put up those same kind of numbers that those other kids have done this year. Get him. Michael Riviera, I've been mentioning him on the last couple podcasts, tight end Oakland. He's got touchdowns in the last 2 games. Get him while you can, because you will not be able to, especially if you need a tight end. Quarterbacks, this is what I need. Hopefully you're not like me. You're pretty set. But if you do need a quarterback, stay away from Drew Stanton. With matchups against the Lions and the Seahawks, I think they both shut him down next week. I like Teddy Bridgewater going up against Chicago, who gives up the most fantasy points to quarterbacks. That's if you need it. You may be streaming fantasy football quarterbacks the rest of the season, like kickers and defenses, for God's sakes. Pick up Josh McDown if you need a weak player this week. After dropping 300 yards in Atlanta, he has Redskins and Chicago, both are at the bottom of the league against quarterbacks. I go pick him up. And also Theo Riddick, who scored a touchdown last week. He's healthier than Reggie Bush and has been more productive than Joe Bell. I like Theo Riddick going forward. Hopefully you guys are all set for week 11. You follow me on Twitter if you need any more help at Dennis77Farrell. You can follow me on Facebook, Dennis Farrell, Farrell. It's a critical time in fantasy football. You need any sit start advice, I'm always around, guys. Good luck. Hopefully you make the playoffs, or at least you're in contention for them going forward, because this is a rough ride now. And most of my leagues, I'm facing some of the top teams at the end of the season, and I'm a little bit worried. I'm banged up. So, as always, guys, good luck in week 11, and Hail Hydra.